In this video, we're going to do an in-depth review of this blue charger that you'll find at Harbor Freight. And we're going to do some tests comparing it to its predecessor, the red charger. And check this out. Got 14 volt output not connected to a battery. I'll show you how you do that later in the review. Now, this started about 6 years ago. After 8 years of faithful service, my Chicago Electric went up in smoke, and I did a video showing what failed in that charger. Then when I picked up the red one, I noticed a lot of confusion, so I did a review of that charger answering some common questions. Now we've got the blue charger, and we're gonna go ahead and unbox this and take a look at it, compare it to the red one. If we pull it out of the box and do a side-by-side comparison, these things look identical. And it turns out if you put a tape measure to it, they are exactly identical in size. The power cord's the same 18 gauge on both, and the battery charge cords are a little heavier duty 14 gauge on both chargers. And I even weighed these things for you guys. We got about a little over 10 pounds on the red, a little under 10 pounds on the blue, and as we open them up, we'll be able to explain that weight difference. When you look inside of these, what you'll find is the windings are the same gauge. So they're both the same quality in terms of the windings, but you've got this extra step down winding here on the red that they've managed to eliminate. So you don't have that weight in the blue, not a reduction in quality. The rectifiers both look good, and a little more solid state on the switch assembly for the blue charger. Rectifier also looks to be of good quality. The output breaker, which is going to give you your full 50 amp, is a 35 amp breaker on both chargers. So you're going to get the same output assist for both chargers. When you connect this thing to the power supply, which is what we're going to do right now, we are going to monitor the voltage at the clamps using this voltmeter, and we're going to put gator clips between the voltmeter and the output clamp. So we'll always know what kind of voltage we're getting on the output. We'll start with the blue charger here. And it says no battery, no output, which is what you should expect. So we'll connect it to the battery, and we're just getting the battery voltage. It's not working. So we better return this charger within the 30-day window because it's clearly not working. Not so fast. Let's look at the instructions first. This thing has a power switch. So if you go into the instructions, you'll notice that it's got all the same LED light functions as the red charger. Tells you while you're charging, tells you fully charged, tells you dead battery. It's got a setting switch for the 2 amp, 10 amp, and starter mode. But then the battery mode switch, which is the regular to AGM, has an off position. And that makes it do nothing. And does nothing is one of the most common review terms for this. So if you don't turn it on, it does nothing. If you don't show it 6.8 volts, it does nothing. If you don't plug it into the wall, it does nothing. If you don't connect it to a battery or you reverse the clamps, it does nothing. So it's pretty easy to get these things to do nothing. So let's compare the faces. The switches on the red go up and down, but has all the same mode settings. The LEDs are the same. The gauge doesn't really have units. It just says percent charge. If you go to the blue charger, of course, the switches are all side by side and it has an off position and it has all the same settings. The LEDs give the same basic information, but I like that the gauge is now amps. So it's calibrated in amps all the way up to 50, and that's my preference. What they both have in common is there's still no backlight on the gauge. I don't know why they do that. So if you're in the dark, bring a flashlight because you're going to need it. Okay, so we do have a power switch, so we're going to turn this thing on now, and we're connected to a battery, so you can see the voltage on the meter climbing. Okay, we're in 2 amp mode. And the voltage is climbing. And if we put it in 10 amp mode, it jumps into the 10 amp range on the gauge, and it'll take the battery up to the top voltage for that mode. Now, here's a review. It says, piece of junk, won't start my Honda Rancher. Well, for those of you that don't know, this is a Honda Rancher, and this is the battery. It's a 400 crank amp battery. 50 amps alone will not start that vehicle. You're gonna need some battery help. For full-size vehicles, they need even more help. Their starters demand a lot of current. This is a typical battery, 750 to 800 crank amp. 50 amps alone is gonna do nothing. You really need to put about an hour of charge on a battery before you're gonna be able to start it. This is a 100 amp battery. It's twice what the chargers put out. It's not gonna be enough to start a vehicle. So you need to put some time on a battery charge. Here is a battery tester. This is gonna act like our starter. This puts a 100 amp draw on the battery. To the chargers, that's going to look just like the starter engaging. So let's go ahead and test that mode. Right now we're in 2 amp. And if you look at the gauge, that's where it's at. It's within the 2-amp area. If I hit the starter, jumped up to 15 amp output without even being in start mode. Now, if we put it into 10 amp mode and engage the starter, we get the full 50 amps, again, without even being in the start mode. Now, if we put it in start mode, it acts just like the red charger. The dial goes back and forth, waiting to see the starter engage, and when we engage it, we get the full 50 amps. So again, when it's in start mode, the needle just goes back and forth on the gauge, hit the starter, you get the full 50 amps. And I can save you guys some time. In both AGM and lead acid regular mode, it behaves the same way. Starter engagement and the 50 amp works the same in both regular and AGM. Now let's look at trigger voltage. Now in the instructions, it says 6.8. Here we have a 3.3 volt battery. And as you can see, when we connect it to, we gotta turn the unit on, when we connect it to the charger, it just gives us a red dead battery LED reading, okay? Because that's what it looks like to the charger. But does that mean it will not work with a battery that's 3.3? Now we're in the red charger. And as you can see, when we connect the red charger to the 3.3, it activates. So the red charger will activate and start a charge process on a battery with 3.3 volts. But if we want to trigger the blue charger, let's try a 9-volt battery. That's greater than the 6.8. Sure enough, in 2-amp mode, we've got a steady output of 14 volts without being connected to a battery. I can touch them. I wouldn't touch them to your tongue, but you can touch these. Until you touch them together, you're going to have a full output. Now, trigger it again. We've got the 14-volt output, and we can now connect it to a battery. And what happens to the voltage? It drops down because now it's got the battery that it's trying to put a charge on. And you can see the voltage climbing. Okay, we pull it off. It goes back up to 14 because there's no battery drawing down the voltage. If we touch the clamps together, of course it stops. Does not hurt the charger. So now we're going to connect it to the battery again. And you can see it's putting a charge on the battery. If we disconnect it, it's still got output in 2-amp mode. Now let's put it to 10-amp mode and see what happens. We disconnect it, it goes to zero. Okay, so in 10-amp, it does not allow continuous output. In fact, if we try to trigger it with a 9-volt battery, it won't stay on without a battery present. We have to go back to 2-amp mode, then we connect to a battery, and if we want to go faster charge, we go to 10-amp mode once we're connected, and that works fine. So you can only trigger the clamps to go live without a battery when you're in 2-amp mode, and I can tell you that it also behaves the same way in both AGM and regular lead acid mode. So now let's look at rescue voltage, and what we mean by that is how low can the battery voltage be and still receive a charge from the charger. So we're going to start, the blue is already activated, I used the 9-volt, and you notice a 1.5 AA dropped it to nothing. So let's try 2 AAs, and these are old AAs, so they actually measure out at a combined 2.89. And we'll reactivate the charger using the 9-volt, so now it's got the 14-volt output, and we'll attach it to the 2.89 volts, and it stays on. So you can rescue a battery once it's triggered as low as 2.89 volts. So now let's look at the red charger. And we can see that the 1.4 is too low. So now we'll do the same thing. We'll double up these old AA batteries, show the red charger at 2.89 volts, and it just gives us a dead battery light. So we know the red charger needs 3.3, and the blue has to be triggered, but it can rescue a battery from 2.89 volts. So now we're going to do a volt range test, and what we're doing is testing the battery modes, the regular versus AGM, and you would expect and you want a deeper cycle with the AGM, and sure enough, within half a volt of each other, both chargers started at about 12.5 and went up to 14.65 in AGM, and in regular lead acid, 12.7 to 14 and a quarter. So that's actually showing good function for the two battery modes for both chargers. Now, pros and cons between these two. People's opinions may vary, so let me know in the comments, but I found that the trigger voltage was a definite advantage for the red because it's lower. The minimum working voltage is lower for the blue once triggered, and the blue is the only one that can have a constant output without a battery. Power switch, advantage blue. And finally, the start mode. Blue gives extra in all modes, and it gives a full 50 in both 10 amp and in starter mode. Okay, so if this helped you guys out, please do give a thumbs up and subscribe for future videos. And to help out anybody else looking at these, please do share this video. Thanks for watching.